Welcome to the Finance Analytics Project. Before we do anything technical, we need to start with the business. Because every meaningful analytics project begins by understanding who the company is, how it makes money, and what challenges it faces. NRG sells a wide range of home and lifestyle products. You can think of it as a mix of three main areas: electronics, home and kitchen, and furniture and living. Each of these departments contribute to both sales and costs, but in slightly different ways. Electronics, for instance, drives a lot of volume, but often lower margins. Furniture tends to have higher margin, but slower turnaround. And together, these departments make up most of the company's total revenue. Now, where does the money go? Like most retailers, NRG's cost falls into two broad categories. First, you have the direct costs, which is what they pay to buy products from suppliers, import goods, and cover transport. These are often called cost of goods sold, or COGS, and they directly affect how profitable each sale is. Second, we have operational costs. Things like salaries, rent, marketing, and logistics. These are day-to-day costs of running stores and getting products to customers. When we put it all together, we can summarize the company's performance with a few simple ideas. Revenue minus direct cost gives you gross profit. And if you then subtract operating expenses, you get operating profit. That's the structure that we're later going to represent in a profit and loss report. Now that you know a bit about NRG's products and cost structure, let's talk about why this context matters. As data analysts, our job isn't just to visualize number, but it's to help the business see what drives them. Knowing how NRG earns and spends money will help us later decide which metrics matters the most and how to organize the reporting. So as you finish this lesson, I want you to take a moment to reflect and ask yourself, what drives revenue for NRG? What are the main cost areas that reduce profitability? And how could analytics help them understand these areas faster or more clearly? Those are some of the questions that we're going to try to keep in mind as we move through this module. In the next lesson, we're going to take these insights and translate them into specific goals and measurable KPIs, the starting point for any good analytics project. Now that we understand what Nordic Retail Group does and how they make money, the next question is, what are they actually trying to achieve? Because when you work as a data analyst or advisor, your real value comes from connecting analytics to business goals. If you don't know what success looks like for the company, it's almost impossible to build something useful. For NRG, management has defined a few clear objectives for the upcoming year. Let's go through them one by one. Goal number one is to improve profitability. Even though sales are strong, operating margins have been flat for several quarters. The company wants to increase overall profitability by around 10%, mostly by improving margins in key departments. That means that we need to focus on KPIs that show how efficiently revenue turns into profit. Things like gross margin percent and operating profits. Goal number two is to control costs. The CFO is particularly concerned about costs rising faster than sales, especially in logistics and marketing. They want more visibility into where money is being spent, and not just the total cost, but also cost by store, department, or activity. So our analysis will need to help identify which areas are overspending and which are performing well. Goal number three is to increase visibility and speed of reporting. Right now, monthly financial reports takes weeks to prepare, and by the time management sees the numbers, decisions are already outdated. They want dashboards that are accurate, consistent, and fast, something that lets them understand how the performance is at a quick glance, instead of waiting for a long time for spreadsheets. So let's translate those goals into something measurable. If the goal is profitability, the key metrics might include total revenue, cost of goods sold, gross margin percent, and operating profit. If the goal is cost control, we might track total expenses, cost per store, and cost as a percent of revenue. And for visibility and speed, we can measure reporting timeliness, data consistency, or even report adoption. Notice how each goal connects directly to a metric. And that's a part of the foundation of good analytics. Every chart, every data set should somewhat link back to something that the business really cares about. I want you to take a moment and think about this. If you were working inside NRG's analytics team, What data would you need to measure these goals? What reports or KPIs would you show the CFO, to a controller, or a head of a department to demonstrate progress? All of these reflections will prepare you for some of the small exercises that we're about to do. You'll find this table inside your finance project workbook. I want you to open it and fill it out as we go. You'll complete a short worksheet where you list three business goals, the KPI that measures each one, and a short note on why it matters. In the next lesson, we're gonna shift from what NRG wants to achieve to the challenges that are holding them back today. The data and process issues that makes reporting slow and inconsistent. But before we can design any solution, we need to understand what's not working today. The real challenges they face in managing and using their data. For NRG, the biggest issue isn't that they lack reports. They actually have quite a few of them. The problem is that those reports don't always agree. The finance team spends days every month combining spreadsheets from stores, accounting systems, and suppliers. And each file looks a little bit different. Sometimes a department uses one naming convention for accounts, while another uses something else entirely. And by the time they've cleaned and aligned all the data, it's already outdated. So when leadership asks what drove our cost increase last month, the answer really depends on who you ask, because each team's version of the truth looks slightly different. The monthly close process has also become a pain point. It can take up to 2 weeks to finalize the numbers, which means that decisions about pricing, campaigns, or staffing often happens based on old information. It's not that the finance team isn't capable, they're just working with systems that weren't designed for fast, integrated reporting. And then there's the visibility problem. Right now, NRG can't easily see which stores are the most profitable, which departments have the highest margin, or where costs are growing faster than revenue. Without a consistent view, every question becomes a manual investigation, pulling data, filtering, recalculating, reconciling differences, and the result? Frustration, delays, and a growing sense that we have data, but we don't have insight. From an analytics perspective, these challenges are exactly what makes this project so valuable. By creating a structured data set, defining consistent account mappings, and automating the flow of data into clear reports, we're gonna give the company a single, reliable version of the truth. And that's what will make everything that follows, the dashboards, the forecasting, the decision-making, faster and more trustworthy. In the next lesson, we're gonna meet the key stakeholders behind this project, the people who will use what we are going to create, and the ones whose questions we need to answer. Now that we understand NRG's goals and challenges, let's take a look at the people behind those goals, the ones who will actually use what we build. Every analytics project has different types of stakeholders, and understanding what they care about is what makes the difference between a dashboard that gets used and one that gets ignored. At NRG, there are three key stakeholders involved in this project. We have the CFO, the finance controller, and the department heads. The CFO is responsible for the company's overall financial health, profitability, cash flow, forecast, and strategic decisions. When they look at a dashboard, they don't want a list of accounts or transactions. They want clarity. High-level KPIs like total revenue, gross margin, and net profit with trends over time. They also want to understand why those numbers change, which departments or stores are driving growth, and which one needs more attention. Next one, we have the finance controller. If the CFO is looking at the big picture, the controller is deep in the details. They care about accuracy, reconciliations, and making sure that every line of the profit and loss statement ties out correctly. They're also the ones who check that the account names, cost allocations, and totals are consistent across departments. Their role is to trust the numbers, so our analytics must be trackable, consistent, and well-structured. And then we have the department heads, the people managing sales, marketing, logistics, and store operations. They don't need every accounting detail, but they do need clear, actionable insights about their own areas. For them, a great dashboard answers questions like, how are we performing against budget? Which stores or products are over or underperforming? Are costs aligned with sales volume or not? When you look at these three groups together, you can see why analytics has to be designed for different levels of detail. The CFO needs the story, the controller needs the structure, and the department heads needs focus and action. Our job as analysts is to connect all three, to make sure they're all looking at the same data, just from the angle that really fits their needs. In the next lesson, we are going to define the project scope and deliverables, what this finance project will include and what it will not include. Now that we understand NRG's goals, challenges, and key stakeholders, it's time to define the scope. In other words, what this analytics project will actually deliver and what's outside of scope. Defining scope is one of the most important things you can do. Without it, you risk trying to solve everything at once and ending up with a lot of effort but little impact. For this project, you are working together with NRG's CFO, finance controller, and department heads to create something practical and focused. A set of analytics outputs that help them make faster, more confident financial decisions. Here's what's been agreed. First, we're going to build a structured finance data set, a clean, consistent foundation that combines revenue and cost data. This will give NRG one version of the truth, something they can trust. Second, we're going to create a profit and loss report that clearly shows how revenue, cost and profit evolve over time. It will break results down by store, department, and periods. Third, we're going to design a balance sheet overview, a summary of assets, liabilities, and equity over time. Fourth, we're going to build an operational performance dashboard, something that department heads can use to compare stores, track budgets, and understand cost efficiency. And once that's in place, we're going to add an advanced analytics layer on top to give management a forward-looking perspective. You can fill out these deliverables directly in your workbook under the scope and deliverables section. It's just as important to be clear about what this project doesn't include. We are not building a full accounting system. We are not integrating directly with the ERP system. We are not automating every data feed from source systems. The focus here is insight and storytelling, helping decision makers understand what's happening in the business and where to focus their attention. In the next lesson, we're gonna turn these goals into analytical questions and KPIs that the data can answer. Now that we've defined the scope, the next step is to translate those business goals into analytical questions and KPIs. This is where the project really starts to take shape, moving from what the business wants to the questions that the data must answer. For each goal that NRG has defined, we're gonna write down one or two questions that the data should answer, and then the KPI that measures it. Goal number one is to improve profitability. And questions might include which store or departments are the most profitable, where have gross margins improved or declined, and what's driving change, revenue, cost, or both. Relevant KPIs here are gross margin percent, operating profit, and revenue growth. Goal number two, control costs. Questions might include which cost areas are growing the fastest, are logistics or marketing costs increasing faster than sales, and how do actual costs compare with budgets? And KPIs here could be total operating expenses, cost as percentage of revenue, or budget versus actual variance. Goal number three is to improve visibility and speed. Questions might include how quickly can we close the month, or are all departments looking at the same numbers? And the KPIs here could be reporting timeliness or data consistency. Each KPI that we define now will later guide us on how we structure the data and what visuals we will use in our dashboard. You'll also complete this part in your finance module one workbook. Open the document, find the analytical questions in KPI section and fill out as needed. In the next lesson, we're going to wrap up module one with a quick recap and transition to the data work ahead. Before we move on to the next module, let's take a quick moment to recap. In this first module, we focused entirely on understanding the business problem. We got to know more about NRG, what they do, how they make money, and what challenges they face. We explored their main goals, improving profitability, controlling costs, and creating faster, more reliable insights. We met the key stakeholders, the CFO, the controller, and the department heads, and we defined the project scope, a data set, P&L report, balance sheet overview, operational dashboard, and also some advanced analytics. And we turned those goals into analytical questions and KPIs, which makes the foundation for everything that follows further on. It's going to be our blueprint and the document that will guide us for the rest of this course. In the next module, we are going to start working on the data, which is going to be the foundation for the rest of this course. So now that we know the why, it's time to move into the how. Let's get started with module two, data ingestion and preparation.